Black Forest Labs has released a model, and it looks like a collaboration with Krea. In this video, we will be looking at the original Flux.1 Krea dev model. I will try the FP8 version of the same model, and also the GGUF models for the low VRAM cards. And finally, the 4-bit Nunchaku model, which is super fast. So, this is the larger dev model, sizing around 24 GB. If you have a flagship graphic card from the 3000 series or newer, then you can download this model. I will begin with the GGUF model. These models are suitable for the smaller graphic cards. You can download this model based on the graphic memory in your computer. I will quickly download some of these models and save them inside the UNET folder. Inside UNET, I made the folder Krea to keep the models separate from the other models. Make sure to update the comfyUI using the update batch file before you begin. This is the simple workflow I will be using to run the model. The node above can be used to load the larger 24 GB model we saw earlier. I have the comfyUI GGUF nodes package installed, and I have used the UNET loader from the GGUF package to load the Q8 model. Next is the clip and the encoder files, which I downloaded from Comfy Anonymous on Hugging Face. Save these files inside the text encoder folder. And then this FP16 model, which is usually paired with the larger 24 GB model we saw earlier. I will be using this FP8 encoder, as it is smaller in size. If you're using the larger model, and it is slow, then you can change the weight from the default to FP8 here. The GGUF is selected here, and the prompt below is about a muscle car in front of a multi-story building, which is an apocalyptic scene. This VAE is the same we use for Flux models. Links to the files will be in the video's description. Click Run to queue the workflow. It takes around 2.77 seconds for a step on my 4060 Ti 16 GB card. After 83 seconds, I got the result. And it looks fine. Looks like there is quite a gap between the larger dev model and the GGUF model. I tried the same prompt with the Q3 model. The time taken for a step was higher, and this is the result. I don't see much difference, but the car looks good in this image. My prompt was about a girl in a nightclub, an old 90s image. The Q3 model looks slower than the FP8 model. The image generated by the 5 GB Q3 model looks fine, and it does not have the chin we usually see in images by the Flux model. What do you think about this image? The 12 GB Q8 model produced a slightly better image, but I think an enhancer will still be necessary on top of the GGUF models. I was expecting better images straight from the model. I will try adding a LoRa in the workflow. This is a Flux-based model, so the LoRa made for Flux.1 dev should work with this model. I have selected the Club Vibe Girls LoRa. Click Run to queue the workflow. And this is the result. The LoRa works, and this model is good at photography-style images. I tried the Alice in Wonderland LoRa and saved it inside the LoRa folder. Select the LoRa in the workflow, use the trigger words in the prompt, and then cue the workflow. And this is the result. I feel like the LoRa has its effect, but not to the fullest. I may be wrong. I used the exact prompt from the Civit AI's image, which gave me this image. Maybe these models were not trained for 3D characters. These two images were generated without using the LoRa. So, it looks like the LoRa did its part, but the models here failed with the 3D character. I added one more LoRa dissolve style in this workflow, because LoRa works. Using both the LoRa, I got this result. The details could have been more, but still, the image generated is good. I will test a few more images later. Let's move ahead to the FP8 model. It's a 12 GB model. Save it inside the diffusion model folder. There is another FP8 model by a different user on Hugging Face, and it has quite a description in its name. Now I will use the Load Diffusion Model node for the FP8 model. I can keep this at the default now. My prompt is about a sports car drifting through a tight corner, and then the dissolve Laura effect. Connect the node and cue the workflow. The generated image you see is by the previous Q8 model. The image generated by the FP8 model does not make much of a difference, and I have seen better results. I downloaded the older Flux.1 Dev Q8 model and the Flux.1 Dev FP8 model for comparison. The image generated by the older Flux Dev FP8 model looks better than the Krea model I used before. The Flux.1 Dev Q8 model also gave a better result than the Krea model. Krea generates realistic images, but you will notice bad structure when the subject is far from the camera. I then tried the other FP8 model we saw on Hugging Face with a longer name. The Laura here in the workflow was a mistake, and the prompt does not include any trigger words. The image looks good. I wonder if it was due to the Laura I forgot to bypass before running the workflow. I queued the workflow again, and now the Laura should not be affecting the result. And this is the result. So, the Laura improved the previous image. I think Flux can give such images without any problems. So, where do the Krea FP8 and the quantized model fit in the ranking chart? Is it around Flux? Maybe just below Flux models? Now, let's look at the Nunchaku models. These are the 4-bit model from the original Flux.1 Krea dev model. The FP4 model above is for 5000 series card, and below INT4 is for other cards. Make sure you have the Nunchaku node package and wheels in your comfyUI. I made this simple video on setting up the Nunchaku workflow. The video link will be in the description if you need it. This is the Nunchaku workflow, and with the 28 steps for image generation, it is still fast. It does generate text in the images if it is not too lengthy. Let's look at the files. This T5FP8 file and the clip-L are the same as we use with the Flux models. And this is the 4-bit model I showed on the Hugging Face. The file is saved inside the Diffusion Model folder. If it does not work on an older card, try changing this data type. These are the LoRa nodes, or I should say the Nunchaku LoRa loader. And here is the VAE similar to the one we use for Flux models. I will try using LoRa, and this yarn LoRa looks good. My prompt is about a lady, and the trigger words for the LoRa. The time taken for a step is similar to what I saw before, and the video is not fast-forwarded. So you can get the idea from my graphic card, which is a 4060 Ti 16GB. The result looks good, but the image on Civit AI is better. I added another LoRa, the dissolve LoRa we saw earlier, without the trigger words, gave a better result. So I tried again. The generation speed is the same as before. The result looks fine, but I feel like this should be processed further for more details. I added the trigger words for dissolve LoRa and tried again. The image is good, but it needs an upscaler. I tried one more LoRa, a detail enhancer, and queued the workflow. The generation time is not affected, and I got the image within 30 seconds. The result looks better than before. I tried the Flux GGUF text encoders, but that gave a non-type object error. Then I tried with the FP16 encoder. My prompt is about a Korean man in a Batman suit with a blurred background. The prompt was from the internet, and the result generated without the LoRA was good. Then I tried an origami kingdom, having a river flowing, a deer and a fox roaming around, and some birds in the sky. The result looks good. I tried the same with the Krea Q8 model. This guy, in the Batman suit, may not be Korean under the mask, but the image looks good. I got the result, and it is not an origami because the LoRA remained active. I generated it again, and this is the result. I will be sharing this workflow in the description as always. The model is good at generating realistic images when the subject is close to the camera, and it is more towards the photography style. It does anime and comics, but other models give better results. Now, we can use all the LoRa and can also avoid the plastic skin and the red faces generated by the Flux models. Let me know your thoughts. Will you be trying these models?